नमस्ते गुरुकुलियंस,
होप यू ऑल आर फिट एंड फाइन एंड सेलिंग इन द बॉट ऑफ जॉय एंड डूइंग स्टडी ऑल्सो। सो बच्चे, इन दिस वेरी लेक्चर वट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस, वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस दैट हाउ वी कैन राइट द केमिकल फॉर्मूला। सो दिस लेक्चर इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग एंड इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज नाउ यू विल कम टू नो दैट हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू यूज H2O for water only, not HO2, HO, why they are not used, only H2O is used for water. So this is very interesting thing that we are going to do today, okay? So first thing, what we need to write a chemical formula, and before that, what is a chemical formula? So beta, what is a chemical formula? The symbolic, what? The symbolic representation of any chemical compound is known as what? Is known as your what, bachchi? Chemical formula. Very good. For example, like here, H2O used for water, very good. CO2 for your carbon dioxide. Okay, so the symbolic representation, because here for hydrogen we use this what symbol? H. For oxygen, O. Symbolic representation of any chemical compound is known as what? Is known as your chemical formula. Good. Second thing, this is what about your definition. What are the things that you need to know before writing a chemical formula? There are two things. First is your symbol. First is the symbol used for element. Used for element. And the second thing is your valency. Second thing is valency, or you can say that combining capacity. Just by knowing these two things, you will be able to write the chemical formula of any of the chemical compounds. Okay? So, starting with the very first thing, symbols used for different elements. As you all know that each and every element has a specific symbolic representation. In the previous part, okay, of this very chapter, we discussed that how the different scientists, they use different methods to represent different elements. Okay, so for this thing, for the first part, that is symbols. For this, up to your standard, you have to remember the symbols of your elements with atomic number 1 to 20. This thing you have to remember. Okay, there is no shortcut, no trick for that. You have to remember each and every symbol used for the elements with the atomic masses, with the atomic number 1 to 20. Okay, the easiest and the simplest method that I used at my time is you have to remember the things. Okay, firstly let me write. This is hydrogen, helium, hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium. Okay, hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium. Now there is a short form, BCNOF, BCNOF, BCNOF. BCNOF means hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, neon. They all are noble gases. First group, second group, 13th, 14th, 15th group, 16 and then 17th one, okay? Hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium, Beckenhoff, neon, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, neon, sodium, magnesium, aluminium, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine, argon, potassium and calcium. This thing you have to remember. Okay, this is a part of your periodic table. Okay, there is no need to remember the whole periodic table, only up to 20 atomic masses you have to remember the things, and it's very easy. Okay, just by doing practice you will be able to learn the things. Some students use another method, that is hydrogen, lithium, sodium, potassium. They remember the periodic table group wise. Okay, but I think it is more easy to remember it in a sequence. Hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, neon, sodium, magnesium, aluminium, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine, argon, potassium and calcium. This thing you have to learn. First thing is with regarding to your symbols. These are the symbols used for your what? Different elements. Very good. The second thing is you have to remember name of some ions also. Okay, there is a table on page number 37 of your NCERT. This table you have to remember once again. For example, taking an example of what are the, because here we represented elements, but here we are going to use ions. For example, sodium symbol is Na, positive, that means plus one charge. Okay, potassium K plus one, with charges you have to remember the formula. Copper exists in two states, plus one or in plus two. Iron, plus 2 and plus 3. They are different charges, you can say, up to your standard, but they are the oxidation states. In higher standard you will come to know what is an oxidation state. Okay, iron, then aluminium, plus 3. These are what? Your metallic ions. These are what, beta? Metallic ions. Another one, non-metallic ions. For example, chloride, Cl negative, nitride, N3 negative, with charges you have to remember. Third is your polyatomic ion. Polyatomic means when number of atoms more than one and of different elements. For example, number first, hydroxide, that is OH negative. If nothing is written after the symbol, that means here one is present. If you write one, it's also okay, and if you don't write this one, it is also okay. Okay, then sulfide, SO3 2 negative. Sulfite and sulfate. Sulfate is SO4 2 negative. This thing you have to remember. Okay, this is the only part where you have to learn the things in chemistry. Okay beta, so that it will be easy for you to write the chemical formula for the compounds. Okay, so the next thing is, after knowing the symbols of elements and ions that are used, second thing is your valency or the combining capacity. The easiest way to know that what is a valency is, bache, if I am having two hands, okay, it is natural that I am having two hands because all the humans will have two hands. So if I am going to hold a person, another person, so that both of hand is occupied, how many person I am able to hold? obviously one, because I am having two hens, he is also having two hens. And but in the case of octopus, octopus is having eight arms, okay. And if octopus wants to hold the human being such that both of his hands were occupied, so how many human beings the octopus can hold? Obviously four, okay. So valency is the combining capacity of any element. That means we know that hydrogen, H is the symbol for oxygen, O is the symbol. But here oxygen or this hydrogen, how we will come to know that how many oxygen this hydrogen can hold? Just by seeing it we can't tell. So this thing we come to know by its valency. That means from the valency we'll know, we can get an estimation that how many oxygen atom this hydrogen can combine with. And same is the case with oxygen, okay. So this is your valency. Now the final part, how we are going to write the formula, starting with your simplest thing, that is water. We know water is made up of what? Hydrogen and your oxygen. These are the requirements, two requirements. There are some rules to write these chemical formula. The rules are very simple. First thing, valency or charge should be balanced. Valency or the charges, valency for elements, charges for ions are balanced. Second, a metal and a non-metal if combined, then metal will come at first place and after that you are going to write the non-metal part. That means while writing the chemical formula, the metal part comes on the left side and the non-metal parts on the right side. That means you have to write the metal part first, because metal is dominating in nature, okay. This is just to remember that metal is of higher priority. Metal star hai bachche. So if he is a star, his place should be first. The third one, in case of polyatomic ions, for example hydroxide ion, already done with a negative charge. So how many hydroxide ions are combined with the another atom? These are represented by using the bracket and by writing their numbers in which they are present in the compound. That means OH hold twice, because this OH is a polyatomic ion, it is a one unit, okay. It is not two different unit, it is a one unit. Very good. So OH, you can't write it O2H2, this is wrong. Polyatomic ion should be written in between the brackets and their multiple is outside the bracket. So these three are your rules and two things are the basic requirements. So for example, water, I know that hydrogen and oxygen. Firstly, you write the symbol part, symbol, then your valency. Hydrogen, we know one. Oxygen, we know two. Okay, then what you have to do, just cross multiply. That means now after cross multiplication, H with 2, oxygen with 1, and in chemical formula the subscript 1, there is no need to write the subscript 1 here. So the formula of water is H2O. Now there is a need to practice different formulas of different compounds. So I'm going to take this as an example. For example, your hydrogen sulfide. Hydrogen first, sulfide S, valency 1, valency 2, cross multiplication, the formula is H2S. Very good. Second one, carbon tetrachloride. Carbon, hame carbon pata bache, we know that carbon and chloride I know. Carbon valency 4, chlorine ion chloride 1 valency, okay. So क्रॉस मल्टीप्लीकेशन CCl4. थर्ड एल्यूमिनियम ऑक्साइड. एल्यूमिनियम एग्जिस्ट इन 3, ऑक्सीजन 2. क्रॉस मल्टीप्लाई. इट इज़ वेरी इजी एंड इंटरेस्टिंग. Al2O3 इज द फॉर्मूला फॉर योर एल्यूमिनियम ऑक्साइड. कैल्शियम ऑक्साइड. कैल्शियम ऑक्सीजन. कैल्शियम 2, ऑक्सीजन 2. क्रॉस मल्टीप्लीकेशन. द फॉर्मूला इज Ca2O2. नाउ देयर इज अ थिंग दैट यू शुड कीप इन माइंड. इफ बोथ द सब्सक्रिप्ट आर सेम, वी कैंसिल आउट ईच अदर एंड द फॉर्मूला इज CaO. दैट इज योर कैल्शियम ऑक्साइड. वाइल राइटिंग द फॉर्मूला यू शुड कीप इन माइंड दैट द सिंबल फॉर कैल्शियम इज कैपिटल C स्मॉल a एंड द सिंबल फॉर ऑक्सीजन इज कैपिटल O. सम स्टूडेंट राइट इट लाइक CaO. C कैपिटल, साइज ऑफ A इज ऑल्सो सिमिलर टू C एंड ऑक्सीजन इज स्मॉलर वन. दिस इज द रोंग मेथड टू राइट द फॉर्मूला. द राइट वन इज फर्स्टली C कैपिटल एंड A इज स्मॉल बिकॉज कैल्शियम सिंबल कैपिटल C स्मॉल a, ऑक्सीजन इज कैपिटल O. ओके. So the next is CaO, we discussed. Next is a case of your what? Polyatomic ions, okay? Calcium hydroxide, calcium hydroxide. Calcium 2 hydroxide, minus 1 charges. Calcium 2 positive oxide, OH negative hydroxide, okay? Cross multiplication, CaOH. Now here we have to use what? Twice. And this is a polyatomic ion because atoms of two different elements are present. So that means we have to use the bracket, and after this bracket we have to write the multiplicator, that is your 2. Fourth one is the formula sodium carbonate. Na stands for sodium and CO3 for your carbonate. Na plus 1 carbonate, 2 negative. So the formula after cross multiplication, Na2CO3. It is also a polyatomic ion, but the multiplicator is 1. So there is no need to use the bracket and write the subscript 1. That means in case of polyatomic ions, the bracket are used only when what beta? When the multiplicator or the subscript is greater than 1. So this is regarding your chemical formula writing. It is very interesting thing, and you have to do the practice, only then you will be able to write the formula of any of the compounds. Okay bachche, so this is your lecture, today's lecture. I hope now you will be able to write the formula and there is no need to cram the formula. But the two things is valency you need to remember, and the second thing, the symbols for the different elements you have to remember. Okay, so okay beta, hope you get the each and everything in the lecture. Okay, thank you.